Welcome to a video on the derivative of an exponential function. The goal of this video is to differentiate exponential functions. Let's go ahead and take a look at the rules. If our base is e, the derivative of e to the x is equal to e to the x. This is actually quite amazing. This function is its own derivative, meaning if we evaluate the function at a given value of x, the function value also tells us the slope of the tangent line at that x value. The second formula here just applies the chain rule. If the exponent is some function in terms of x, we'd apply the chain rule and the derivative would be e to the u times a u prime. Now, if the base of the exponential is not e, then notice the derivative would have an extra factor of natural log a times a to the x. And then again, this last rule is if we have a raised to some function in terms of x, we would have to apply the chain rule. So we'd have natural log a to the u times u prime. Let's take a quick look at a rough proof of the derivative of the function f of x is equal to e to the x. We start with the basic exponential function, apply the limit definition of derivative, do our substitution, do some fancy algebra here, factor out a to the x, and what we have is a to the x times this special limit. And what we're going to argue now is if we knew the value of a that would make this limit equal to 1, then we would have the case where the exponential function is its own derivative. And so what we do is we take that special case over here. What would a have to be in order for this limit to equal 1? Well, if we assume it's equal to 1, solve it for a to the h, and raise both sides of the equation to the power of 1 over h, we'd have a equal to this expression here, which we could then conclude that if this limit is equal to 1, then a would be equal to this limit here. And by definition, this limit is equal to e, therefore we have a equal to e. So when a is equal to e, going back over to the left side, we have the derivative of e to the x is equal to e to the x. Now you may want to pause and take a closer look at this proof, but that's a general idea. Now the next case is, what do we do if the base isn't e? Well, from some of our properties, we can rewrite a to the x as e to the power of x times natural log a. And in this form, we can just apply the chain rule to the derivative of e to the u. So what we're saying here is that the derivative of a to the x is equal to this derivative. So if we let this equal e to the u, the derivative of this function would be e to the u times u prime. Now, natural log a is just a constant, so the derivative of u is just 1 natural log a, which gives us natural log a times a to the x when a does not equal e. Again, you may want to pause the video to take a closer look at this, but that's the general idea. Let's go ahead and put it into practice. Let's say we want to find the derivative of each of these functions. So to find the derivative of this function, we are going to need this derivative formula, e to the u times u prime, where our value of u is equal to 6x. So first, we have the derivative of this term, which would be 10x to the fourth minus 3 times, here's our formula, e to the u times u prime. That would be e to the power of 6x times u prime. The derivative of 6x would be 6. We can clean this up to 10x to the fourth minus 18 e to the power of 6x. Now, number two, we have to realize that this is a product of two functions. We'll call the first function f and the second function g. So we're going to have to apply the product rule. And so what I've done already is set this up. We have the first function times the derivative of the second plus the second times the derivative of the first. Let's go ahead and find these derivatives and then simplify. Now, the derivative of e to the power of negative 2x, we are going to have to apply the chain rule again. So our derivative is e to the u times u prime. So we'd have e to the power of negative 2x times negative 2 plus e to the negative 2x times the derivative of x to the third, that would be 3x squared. We'd have negative 2x cubed e to the negative 2x plus 3x squared e to the negative 2x. Now I will factor this one. We can see these two terms have a common factor of x squared e to the negative 2x. Now if we factor this out of the first term, we'd be left with negative 2x. If we factored x squared e to the negative 2x out of this term, we'd have a positive 3. So I'll put the positive 3 first and the minus 2x second. And now there's a derivative in factored form. Let's go ahead and try another. Here we have a quotient. So on the right side here, I wrote out the quotient rule. Remember, it's low d high minus high d low, low low. And over here on the left, I've already set it up. We have the denominator times the derivative of the numerator minus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator all over the denominator squared. The derivative of e to the power of 3x would be e to the 3x times u prime, so there are 3, minus e to the 3x times 6x to the 5th, all over x to the 12th. Let's clean this up and then see if we can factor it. Now I notice the numerator has a common factor of 3x to the 5th e to the 3x. Let's factor that out. So we'd be left with x minus 2 over x to the 12th. And we can see that we have an x to the 5th here and x to the 12th here. This would simplify and this would become x to the 7th. So our final derivative would look like this. Okay, let's try another question. Determine the slope of a tangent line to the function at the given point. Well, we know in order to find the slope of the tangent line, we have to find the derivative of this function. Let's go ahead and do that. It would be 2 times the derivative of e to the power of 3x. Again, hopefully we're pretty good now recognizing that our u would equal negative 3x. So we're going to have e to the negative 3x times a negative 3. So our derivative function is negative 6 e to the negative 3x. If we want to find the slope of the tangent line at this point, we need to evaluate this function at x equals 0. Of course, e to the 0 would be 1. Negative 6 times 1 gives us a slope of negative 6. Let's go ahead and graph this function and check our work. So here's our function. Here's our point of tangency. The question is, does this line have a slope of negative 6? If we start up here and go down 6 units and write 1, we have the correct line, which verifies our work. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more application question. More Americans are buying organic fruit and vegetables made with organic ingredients. The amount A of T in billions of dollars spent on organic food T years after 1995 can be approximated by this function. We have two questions to consider. Estimate the amounts that Americans will spend on organic food in the year 2009. So the question is, what value of T are we going to use? Well, based upon the question, 1995 was our base year. So we have to take our desired year and subtract 1995. This will give us 14. So this is not a calculus question. We just need to evaluate A at a value of 14 for T. Second natural log brings up the base E. We have approximately 30.2. Now, if you recall from the question, it was $30.2 billion. A of T was in billions. And the last question, estimate the rate at which the spending on organic food was growing in the year 2006. Whenever we hear that word rate or rate of change, we should be thinking derivative. So we need to evaluate the derivative. Let's start by finding our value of T. That's going to give us a t value of 11 for this question. But on this one, we want to find the rate of change. We need to find the derivative. Remember, the derivative of this would be e to the u times u prime. Of course, t prime. Of course, u prime would be 0.18. So simplifying this, we would obtain the derivative function here. So if we simplify this, we'd obtain this derivative function. And now we need to evaluate this at t equals 11. Which gives us approximately 3.17. Again, this is in billions of dollars, but it's a rate, so billions of dollars, and time is in years, so per year, at that instant where t is equal to 11. Now I'm gonna go back to the graphing calculator just for a moment and show you another way you can check your work. This graphing calculator will evaluate derivatives at a specific value of x, or in this case, t. So if we hit our math key and scroll down to option 8. If we type in the original function, now I'm going to use x instead of t, then type in comma x, comma the value of x we want to determine the derivative at, which is 11, it will give us the same answer. It's a nice way to check, but I'm sure your instructor will want you to show the derivative function. Okay, I hope that helps explain how to find the derivative of exponential functions. Thank you for watching.